Hey everybody, I am Sean Battle here with the man, Matt Layton. And today we're going to talk about the Amazon effect. Everybody's talking about it, the Amazon effect of our local real estate market. So first, I think that really what's going to happen is the rental market's going to boom first. We've got a lot of millennials moving into the area. Mm-hmm. Millennials are going to tend to rent first, at least for a couple of years, and they're going to want to rent locally, close to work, I think next to the metro stops, next to the cooler areas. So along the blue line, orange line, yellow line, they're going to be there.
Yeah, renters are going to see the most immediate impact. And I see on Twitter, everyone is complaining about, oh, I'm going to be priced out of the area. There's going to be 25,000 new people moving in. And I think there's a lot of misinformation out there because the most immediate impact is going to be on the rental market, but it's not something where your landlord's going to give you a letter tomorrow and say that you need to double your rent or move out. And there's not going to be 25,000 new cars on the road either in terms of traffic. The reason that they chose Amazon, Arlington, one of the reasons is because there's a lot of local talent here. They're not going to bring in 25,000 new people. They're going to take from the local job pool, and they're right next to public transportation. So I don't see a huge impact in traffic, but for renters, I think immediately there's a lot of supply, but I think you're going to see a lot of change right there.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, think about 25,000 new jobs. What does that equate to for people moving into the area and people already here that are living here? So 10,000 people, I don't know what that is, but I mean, it's going to affect that market. It's going to be the rental market first. Then it's going to go into the sales market. That's what everybody wants to know about. So buyers, yeah, is really what we're talking about. How many buyers are going to be coming into our area? Well, there's five things I think that we've got to think about. First, it's the local effect. It's all those people that have been in the market last year that tried to get in, weren't able to get in, that are now pressed. They're thinking, I've got to get in before everybody else does.
If you're a buyer and you're thinking about buying, this is one of those times where maybe it makes sense, but make no mistake about it. If you weren't thinking about buying and all this is happening and you're hearing all this pressure, don't buy because Amazon is coming and the world is ending and real estate's no longer going to be affordable. You want to make sure you're buying for the right reasons, whether it's Nestle moving to Roslyn or Amazon moving to Crystal City. There's always going to be those external factors. Interest rates are rising, but you should only be buying because you want to buy. So if you were thinking about buying now or in 6 months, maybe it's a good time to strongly consider that. If you weren't thinking about buying, or maybe you're thinking about buying in 12 months, maybe it's a wait and see game. It's not something where you go out there, oh my God, my real estate agent said the real estate market's hot, I need to buy. Only buy if it makes sense and if that's right, something that you want to do in the first place.
Yep, exactly. The second thing I think we're going to see is investors. We're already seeing this now.
Big time.
So the investors are going to fly in. They're going to start buying the stuff and holding. We've already seen this, Matt.
Lots of 310 area codes. I don't know where that is, but it's all cash buyers that want something along the blue line. I think the blue line, this is a prime opportunity. The blue line's often been like the stepchild of the metro corridors. A lot of the action has always been on the orange line and on the red line and then even towards the green line.
Ugh. Really?
the green line's kind of cool. H Street. Shout out to H Street. But I think that a lot of opportunity is going to be in Delray, Potomac Yard, Huntington, and Springfield, those types of neighborhoods.
Yeah, definitely. Then the next one, the third effect, is the actual buyers from Amazon. Now, how many is that going to be? So we've got 25,000 new jobs. We've got, you know, if you took 40% of that and said 10,000 might be coming from outside of our area, I don't know. And then how many of those people are actually going to buy per rent? You know, so we got to think about those numbers and figure out how many that is. And is it actually going to happen over time? How many years is this going to take? Some people are saying the amount of people that are going to be moving here the first year might only be 400. So that's not really going to have a huge effect on our market. Your thoughts?
This is a long-term play. This isn't something that's going to spike immediately. You're seeing some properties in Crystal City right now that have been on the market actually raise their price. So we were talking to another agent in our DC office, Rob Carter. He was saying that if the market rejects your original price and you've been on the market for a month, and then you raise that price $20,000, do people think Amazon employees are idiots? Like, they're going to be making over $150,000. They're making that for a reason. They're not idiots. So,
I think that there's a lot of hype right now, and people are thinking that this hype is going to transition to a higher price right away. I think it's a mistake. Raising your price right now is not the answer. You've been on the market. We're really in a slower fall market before this all hit. So, to raise your price in a slower fall market, it, to me, just doesn't make sense.
Yeah, I think this is going to lead up to a stronger spring market. A lot of agents have been saying that the market is shifting. Things are changing. Tom Ferry goes, the market is shifting. You need to adjust. I don't see it. I know you and some other people, but if anything, all right, let's say the market has shifted. It's still a seller's market. And then because of Amazon, it's still going to be that much stronger of a spring market if people thought it was slowing down.
It's true. And the reason we were getting that prediction is because they look at things in a 10-year prediction. And if you go 10 years back, we were in 2008, which was one of the worst markets we've ever seen. So they were saying that this was going to happen. And honestly, I started feeling it. I felt like, there were certain properties that were sitting longer. We're seeing a lot of drops, but we see that every fall. But I felt like it was happening a little bit stronger than normally. But now with this news, we are seeing a little bit of uptick. We actually, this past weekend, we had two properties on Sunday, got offers on both of them. One had multiple offers after it had been on for 18 days.
Yeah.
So you just never know when this is going to affect and who it's going to affect.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of stories of investors coming in, buying up properties that are along the metro line, even now and even when the rumors were starting. So if you're a seller, you're definitely in a good spot right now.
Definitely in a good spot. Number four, after these renters have been here for a few years, they're going to start buying.
Yeah.
So not only are we going to see the transition of Amazon coming here slowly, but we're also going to see the transition of the renters actually buying. They're saying, well, why am I sitting here renting, watching everybody else's price values go up? I should get into the market. So that's going to flood the market again with the millennial renters that moved here from Amazon into the market.
Yeah, and let's talk about neighborhoods for a second, because people are saying, all right, Crystal City, that's the place to be. Guys, have you ever seen a property in Crystal City? You want a condo? You're paying $1,000 in condo fees, and it's going to be built in the 1970s, and you might not have washer and dryer in unit.
There are a few here and there. Yeah, you're right. Most of them are older. Condo fees are really high.
Yeah.
There's one, actually, a property that I used to own a condo in that...
it's a good building.
It's a great building.
Bella Vista.
Bella Vista. All the utilities are included in your condo fee.
Yeah.
And they're reasonable condo fees. It's right there.
So you have slightly older inventory. You also have single family homes walking distance to Crystal City, walking distance to the metro, to the mall. So you have opportunities within Crystal City, but I think if you're a millennial, if you're a first-time home buyer, if you're an Amazon employee, you might look at Crystal City, but there's going to be a lot of hot neighborhoods like Delray, Potomac Yards. Pulte's built a lot of new homes right in Potomac Yards.
Ton of townhouses, condos, all brand new. It used to be vacant land. Now it's really built up, looks great. It'll also transition into Old Town and North Arlington. Along the Orange Line, it's hot. This is where people want to be. So, it's only three stops away. So
we've said Blue Line, we've said Orange Line, we've mentioned DC is also gonna be a big area, maybe Southwest Waterfront, maybe Navy Yard, H Street, easy access into Crystal City. But we were talking to some agents yesterday, and I'll name the office, Frederick, and they were saying that they're gonna see a boom. I'm not buying that someone's going to buy in Frederick.
If you're thinking to buy in Frederick because you see the prices, think again, because the commute is ridiculous. You might see an hour right now if you just drive it, but in traffic, it's 2 hours.
Maybe what they're saying is Frederick might increase in value because those people that maybe were considering being a little bit close in would be eventually priced out and would have to go
to
Frederick.
But that's true.
I don't believe that this is going to be a blanket thing where every single neighborhood is going to increase in value. I think it's going to be over time. I think it's going to take a while. Rental immediately, investment immediately. Buy if you want to buy right now. And if you're a seller and you don't want to sell, great. Don't sell. Don't let any real estate agent tell you you should
you
sell.
You gotta sell now.
Yeah.
I mean, it really depends on your situation. Sell on your situation.
Yeah.
And then the fifth thing, there's five things I think that are gonna happen. Other businesses coming into our area, following Amazon's lead. We were already seeing a few being talked about. Virginia Tech in the Potomac Yard area.
Innovation Center. And then there's also Apple that is looking for a new headquarters. And, you know, Arlington's going after that and they stopped. And now Fairfax County is actually going after a new Apple headquarters. We'll have to find a way to link that below. But like you said, you know, a good strategy is to buy near a Whole Foods, right? Buy a house near a Whole Foods.
Yeah.
A good business strategy is, you know, follow Amazon.
Follow Amazon.
Where's Amazon going?
So all of these combined are going to have a great impact on our market for years to come, I think. I don't think this is a quick thing. This is a slow progression to a great real estate market. I think locally we have been spoiled with a great real estate market for years, and it's just going to get better. You want to go into some stats?
Sure, what do you got? Right.
So stats, 2017, I'm looking inside the Beltway just in Virginia. Think about this, there's 8,800 total sales inside the Beltway in Virginia.
So 9,000.
So basically 9,000, okay? 2017 was the highest number that we've seen in years, as far as I went back. That was the highest number of transactions inside the Beltway. Of that, about 3,150 were in Arlington.
Okay.
And about 2,650 were in the city of Alexandria. All the other sales were in like Falls Church, Annandale, McLean. So we're talking inside the Beltway. So if we think about an increase of how many buyers to the market, let me just give you a statistic. There were 826 new transactions, was the largest increase we've seen year over year for the last 10 years. And that was in 2012. In 2012, the 2 years prior to that, we saw two decreases in transactions. So we followed up from a slow market into a good market, and we saw 826 increased transactions. So if Amazon has an 800 transaction year, that's going to increase our buyer pool by 10%. Think about it.
Yeah, so an increased buyer pool of 10%, it's definitely going to add to the buyer pool, but again, long term, like we're not in Des Moines, Iowa. Like this isn't something where properties are just going to like sell for like absurd amounts of price.
The
price is already in. And think about Seattle when Amazon came there. Seattle was, you know, kind of this mediocre city, nothing against Seattle, but you know, DC's established. We already have the government. We already have high property taxes, high property values. Seattle, when Amazon came, just flipped it on its head. DC, you know, it's gonna increase, but guys, we're already there. So, you know, it might bump it up a little bit.
And that's what they're saying is, you look at the millennial buyers or the new buyers, these people are making, you know, good money, $100,000+. But in this area, you need a lot of money to be able to afford the area. We're already finding a property in the high threes is a one bedroom property.
Yeah.
So you've really gotta think about how much further can it go? Hopefully it goes, but if you're an owner, right? For owners, hopefully it goes. But, you know, now the question is, do you sell on the news? Do you hold and hope the values go up?
Yeah, I think there might be an opportunity if you're a seller and you were already gonna sell in 2019 to come on the market a little bit earlier just to test it out, to get ahead of that spring market. I think that's the big opportunity. Also, big winners, buyers that bought last year that are now owning property along the blue line, that they just see, you know, instant equity. That was a great buy last year or maybe 2 years ago, whenever you bought.
Yep, exactly. So, you know, depending on when people try to sell, I mean, this could either pull back the inventory, which if they decide to hold, they're going to pull back the inventory and that'll cause prices to rise. Or, you know, they're going to flood the market thinking, hey, let's sell on the news. Let's sell now, because I think this is our best opportunity to get the best price that we can. It'll flood the market and, you know, it could go either way at that point. So.
Cool.
So that's it.
Is that about it?
I think it's gonna have a good effect over the next 5 years. I think we're gonna see a lot of increased value, great competition. So if you're looking to buy, sell in the area, you're looking at us, right?
Cool.
Call us, let us know. I'm Sean Battle.
Matt Layton, thanks for watching.